Welcome back to LearningStrome Academy. So friends, today the topic that we are going to discuss is logical predecessor. But friend, before starting the video, please subscribe our channel so you can directly get our videos. Okay, so friend, yes, we are going to discuss about logical operators. So let's start, friend. So friend, actually logical operators also seems simple, but we need to discuss something about it that is important. Okay, so we are going to discuss today in this video what which kind of data is valid for it. Okay, which kind of conditions or in which kind of scenarios we need to use the logical operator. Okay, and what is the difference between bitwise and logical operator, and okay, which operator is good for performance wise. Okay, and what are the difference between them, we are going to discuss all about in this video. Okay, so please till this video, watch this video till last. Okay, so let's start the video. So friend, these operators are used to perform actually logical and logical or and also logical complement operation. Okay, so actually friend, the logical operators are also known as short circuit operators in Java. Okay, so don't be confused if anyone says that perform the short circuit operation on this kind of data. So don't be confused that what is short circuit operator. So you don't be confused with it. Okay friend, so actually friend, the main areas where we use logical operators are where we have to test the several conditions. Okay, and we want to combine them, okay, together. In that case friend, we use a logical operators. Okay, let's take an example friend. If I want, let's consider a scenario where I want to check a particular character lies between the smaller alphabet range or not. Okay, so in this case friend, I need to check two conditions. The particular character is it greater than A or equal to A, and it is lesser than equal to Z. Okay, then I have to need to check both these two conditions. Okay, so friend, in such kind of scenario we use the logical operator friend. So let's start the first operator of the logical, that is logical and. Okay friend, so logical and friend, it is denoted by double ampersand sign. Okay friend, it will return true when both conditions are true. Okay, let's consider an example. We have two conditions X and Y. Okay friend, here friend, if the first condition is true, then only Y will be going to evaluate. Okay, if the first condition is false, then the friend Y is not going to evaluate. But friend, in case of bitwise, and if the both conditions is always evaluated, okay, it doesn't matter first is false or second is false, it doesn't matter, both conditions are always evaluated. Okay friend, okay, so logical operator friend, actually friend, it returns true if the first, if at least one condition is true. Okay, if the at least one condition is true, then it is going to give us true. Okay friend, so let's suppose we have two conditions X and Y. Okay friend, as I said, at least. Okay, so if the first condition is true, then second is not going to value, because I said at least, if one of them is true, it meant the answer will be true. Okay, so if the second condition is going to valid only if the first one is false. Okay, so keep it in mind friend. Okay, why will be here, the second condition will be evaluated only if the first condition is false. Okay, this is all about logical operator. So friend, logical not friend, actually used for inverting a boolean value. Okay, but not for integral types. Okay friend, as in as you know friend, when we are trying to complement a boolean value with a bitwise complement operator, in that case friend, we will get a compile time error. Okay, but friend, if I want to complement such kind of values, then how we can complement it, then in that case friend, for this we use the logical not operator. Okay, but friend, logical not operator is not applicable for the integral type. If you want to complement the integral type, then friend, you need to use the bitwise complement operator. Okay friend, as this is also known as boolean complement operator, because friend, actually it is only works for boolean value. Actually friend, logical and logical all and logical not, all these operators also known as boolean and boolean not or boolean or operator, because friend, this the only valid kind of data for the logical operators are boolean data. Okay, we cannot work with any other kind of data. Logical data operators cannot work with another kind of data. Okay, they cannot work with integral, or they cannot work with the float or other kind of data. The only valid data for the logical friend operators are boolean data. Okay, So friend, if we try to use Boolean complement operator with the integral values, in that case friend, we will get a compile time error, that the bad operator, okay, we cannot apply to it. Okay friends, this is the cases that we have to discuss. Okay friend, before so friend, let's see what is the difference between bitwise and logical friend. But I before watching the difference, we should do some examples. Okay, so you all thing will be clear to you. Okay friend, so first let's clear the screen. Okay friend, so first I would like to say that if I want to perform logical operations friend, so let's see which kind of data is valid. First you need to see, okay, this. So let's compile this program. So for this we need to write the name of the program, the name of the program logical, name of the class is logical. Okay, let's compile this program. After compiling this friend, we are going to get an error. The error is that bad operand types, the type of operand is not valid for the logical. As I said you friend, the only valid type for the logical operators are Boolean, but here we are trying to use integer, that's why we are getting an error. So for the friend, now if I want to make this program run, so for this I need to take always a Boolean value. So here let's see a Boolean values. Okay, see friend, we have a Boolean value true and false. Now friend, our program is going to work fine. Okay, so this is for, this is all about the logical operator. Okay, so friend, one more thing, see, we are going to get a true. So from here friend, it is also clear that for our operator, one, at least one condition should be true. See here, first condition is true, so second is not going to evaluate, our compiler is going to give us answer true for on the behalf of the only first condition. Okay, if the first condition is false, when in that case friend, our compiler is going to check also the second condition. If it is true, in that case friend, our compiler will give us true. Otherwise friend it will give us false. See friend, here we are getting true. If the first condition is false, then our compiler is going to check this condition, and after this condition friend, if it is true, our compiler is returning us true. If it is false friend, in that case friend, we will get a false as an output. See, and now friend, we are going to get an output. See friend, we are getting false as an output. Okay, so this is all about the logical OR operator. Okay, now it is clear to you friend, what is the valid kind of data for the logical operator, is only Boolean data. Okay, okay, and let's use the AND operator. Okay friend, if I want to use AND operator friend, so as I told you, both for this, both conditions should be true. If both conditions should be true, then the result, then only the result will be true. Okay, see, let's compile this program and let's run this program. See friend, now we are getting true. Okay, the both conditions are true friend. If the first condition is false, in this case friend, our second condition is not going to evaluate. In this case friend, our compiler is going to give us false. Okay, if the first condition is false friend, in this case we are getting a false as an output. See friend, we are getting false and as output. Okay friend, so if the first condition is true, then friend, our compiler is going to check also the second statement. If it is true, then our compiler is going to throw in true. If it is false, then it is, our compiler is going to give us false as an output. Okay, see, I'm going to compile this program and see, we are getting false as an output. So this is all about the logical logical and OR operator friend. One more thing friend, as we know, we cannot apply bitwise complement operator on the Boolean type. But friend, if I want to convert complement Boolean number, so how can I do? For this friend, we have a logical operators. Okay, if I want to complement my Boolean expression, okay, in this Boolean Boolean kind of data, for so I can use the bitwise complement operator friends. Okay, so now I have a true as an output, and I'm going to convert it as a see friend, we are getting false. Okay, I'm inverting this true into false by with the help of bitwise complement operator friend. So this is logical complement operator friend. So this is all about the logical operators. So friend, let's discuss the difference among bitwise and logical operator, which is very important friend, from the interview point of view. Okay, so friend, first of all friend, we bitwise operators are denoted by single and or single and a single or, okay, and the logical and or denoted by double ampersand sign and double or double pipe symbol, okay, friend. In the case of bitwise and or operator, friend, both argument should be evaluated always, okay. But in case of second, in case of logical operator and operator and or operator, friend, second argument evaluation is always optional. Keep it in mind, okay, friend. Second point, friend, relatively performance is low. Why? Because, friend, we need to evaluate always the both conditions always. But in case of logical, friend, in case of performance is high. Okay, friend. Why performance is high? Just because, friend, here, friend, in the logical operator, we are not evaluating second. Okay, it is optional. Okay, if the result is we are getting result true from the first condition or getting false from the first condition, we are not going to evaluate the second, okay. That's why from the performance is high with the use of the logical operator, okay. Third line that is very important, friend, that we can applicable bitwise and or operator is applicable for both integral and the boolean types, okay. But friend, logical and or operator is, friend, only applicable for the boolean types, not for the integral type. So this is the main difference between bitwise and or logical and bitwise and or and logical and or, okay, friend. So I hope you like our video, okay, friend. So keep this, share this video more and more, okay, friend, and subscribe our channel, okay. So okay, bye bye, friend.